Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Devany, and today I'm gonna be making hot chocolate bombs. But before we get started, please hit that like and subscribe button. Here we go. So everyone's seen hot chocolate bombs around lately. They're the most popular thing on Instagram and TikTok and whatever. But they're expensive, and I wanted to give them a try without spending $5. So I'm gonna make them for the first time, and I'm gonna bring you along for the ride. So basically, I'm following a recipe, and it says I need a silicone baking pan, so I've got one of these. You can find them a few places right now, since these things are so popular and everyone's making them and selling them for Christmas. They're kind of getting hard to find, and the price is going up like every day. So if you can get your hands on one, do it. So I've got that, and I've pretty much just got chocolate. I have Lindt Swiss chocolate, milk chocolate. So we're gonna try it with a chocolate bar, because nowhere does it say what type of chocolate to get. It just says quality, and Lindt is my version of quality. So in my bowl here, I've got 8 ounces of chocolate, which is about 2 1/3 of those chocolate bars. And we're just gonna heat it up for 15 seconds. Mix it up and keep doing that until it's like a smooth, melted but not melted consistency. So we got 15 seconds. Hopefully this bowl doesn't melt. So it's starting to melt, and what we're doing right now is called tempering the chocolate. We just want it to melt evenly. So we're gonna stir from the outside in for just to make sure it evenly melts. The outside's obviously gonna melt faster than the middle. So you just mix around and then we'll keep going. Something I've noticed about chocolate, it does different things depending on the bowl or materials that you're using. So this bowl is melting the chocolate faster than other ones I've used. I don't know if this bowl is microwave safe, and I kind of hope it is, but it's melting a lot faster than other things I've used for chocolate. So I think we just got one more and it should be okay. Perfect. All right. So it's melted. Let's be real. Some of those recipes say like you want it not fully melted, but it's chocolate. And I don't know what in between melted is. So it's melted. It looks pretty even to me. But we're going to spoon a little bit into our silicone mold and spread, I'm thinking, a thin layer. Try to make sure we do the edges so when we do pop it out, it doesn't break. I'm gonna use a brush because different videos use different things, but it just seems easiest. So pretty much painting the inside. With our room temperature mold and your like warm or hot chocolate, whatever, this part's gonna be easy. I've seen some people do it with a spoon, like the back of a spoon, but that, I don't know, that seems difficult to me, like spreading with a spoon. But the brush, I highly recommend. This is done, and I'm just going to tip out the excess onto a silicone mat. And like I said before, I love silicone mats because easy cleanup. And this cleanup's gonna be the best because you can just eat the chocolate off of it. Oh, I guess there is no excess, so that's awesome. Gonna touch up a couple spots that look a little bit thin. I think what you need to focus on in this is the bottom and the sides. The sides, you don't want them to crack when they come out. And the bottom, you want them like relatively sturdy that it holds its structure. So we put it back in our baking pan. I'm using a baking tray because this is gonna go in and out of the fridge. Like we're gonna have to cool it. And I just want something sturdy. This one's I think it's stainless steel. So I think it's actually gonna cool it down faster, but I don't know how it's gonna be if you just pick up the silicone. It's gonna be a little wobbly. So we'll put it in the fridge for 5 minutes and we'll be back in a bit. So it's been about 5 minutes and I've taken our mold out of the fridge. We're gonna now do our second layer just so we have that, I guess so we make it more sturdy. This time I'm just gonna paint it on because if I pour the chocolate directly into the mold, this mold is cold. It's been in the fridge for 5 minutes. I don't know how this is gonna work though because it's also probably freezing the chocolate that I have on the brush. But this second coat, I'm only doing two coats. I've, in all of the recipes that I've seen, no one's done more than two. So my main focus on this one is the sides. We want our sides to be super coated so they're sturdy. So when we take it out, we don't have problems. I think I'm also going to pay extra attention to the middle of each one, just because, I don't know, it seems like it's on those first two at least, like the third one that I'm doing now, it seems a little more sturdy on the bottom, but the first two, like the heat of the chocolate and the heat of the melted chocolate and the cold of the one that was in the mold seems to have taken some off the bottom. And with these 8 ounces of chocolate, no recipe actually told me how much they make. So I don't know if it's gonna only make these, we're gonna have 6 semicircles right now, but this only makes 3 of the hot chocolate bombs. I don't know how many it actually makes start to finish. So I guess we'll find out. And any air bubbles I'm finding, I'm just covering over them. Just in case. I don't know if this makes any difference, but who knows? Just want it to be as covered as possible. Gonna make sure the bottoms are all covered. And that's it. So I'm gonna put these back in the fridge for about another 5 minutes, maybe 7. We'll see how hard they are. We want them like completely solid this time because next we're taking them out of the molds. All right, so it's been like it's been a while. And we've taken them out of the fridge. And so we're just gonna pop them out of the molds. Since they're silicone, this should be really easy. It's easier than it looks right now. I'm just being really careful. This one broke on the bottom because I pushed too hard. So we've got our six. We're gonna fill four of them with hot chocolate. I just got regular hot chocolate from the store. You can make yours, but I wasn't gonna go all out since I've never done this. So I'm just putting one scoop. Some of the recipes said use like a tablespoon, but whatever, use what you want. I'm gonna add just a little bit more in each. And then you could put whatever else in here you want. You could put candy canes, sprinkles. If you can find it, you can get those Lucky Charms marshmallows. I just have regular marshmallows. I couldn't find the freeze-dried ones, so I just got normal mini marshmallows and cut them up. We just put them in our, I have a lot, so I'm gonna put a lot in here. In our molds. And then I have a hot plate of sorts. It's just like a steel thing that I've heated up for a couple seconds. I've also seen people online use like a bowl or a plate that they put a little bit of hot water in it and then put in the microwave for a few seconds, dry it off, and then you use that for this to do the top. I'm actually gonna use gloves with this because I think my hands are warm and they're gonna make them melt a little faster. Just gonna put it on our hot thing for a couple seconds so it's all gummy. And then just stick them together. It should be pretty easy to do. They should line up, I mean, pretty perfectly. Yep, I think this one I might have to melt again, but it's getting really soft. Oops. I don't know if that one's working out. Things are happening. Balls don't seem to match. I think the bottom just blew out. Okay. So they're on. And we're just gonna put them in the fridge to cool for about 30 minutes. So we'll do that and we'll be back. So it's been about 30 minutes and they're out of the fridge. They're pretty solid. Like I can pick it up, shake it around, whatever. We're just gonna test it and see if this thing works. So we put it in the cup. We don't want it to break. Move you guys out of the way. I think it worked. So I guess you do have to mix it up because obviously you're just gonna have like stuff sitting in your milk, but it works and that's awesome because I just saved myself $5. So yeah, so if you like this video, please like and subscribe, and you can also follow me on Instagram. And if you see any more cool DIYs online, put those below in the comments and maybe we'll try it out. And we will see you in the next video. Thank you.